HBO's new series Watchmen takes place 30 years after the events in the graphic novel, so there are a lot of references to the original story in the first episode. Here's everything you might have missed. And warning, spoilers ahead. The show opens in the middle of the 1921 Tulsa race riot, a real event in which the white residents attacked black residents and businesses. The riot destroyed more than 35 square blocks, injured over 800 people, and left over 100 people dead. The boy then wakes up with a blood splash across his forehead, resembling the iconic blood splash from the cover of the Watchmen graphic novel. Oklahoma is being performed at the Dreamland Theater. This is the same theater we saw in the 1921 riot scene. We then get a quick glimpse of a television showing Dr. Manhattan on Mars, where he went to after the events in the original story. During the brief glimpse that we get of the stream, we see Dr. Manhattan standing in front of what appears to be Vate's castle made out of dirt, which we see later in the episode. Angela mentions that she was born in Vietnam. This refers to the fact that in the Watchmen alternate timeline, the United States won the Vietnam War because of Dr. Manhattan, and Vietnam became the 51st state. This is further displayed in the 51 stars of the US flag. Angela and her son Topher hear an alarm sound before tiny squid fall from the sky. It appears that the squid-like monster summoned by Ozymandias at the end of the Watchmen graphic novel has somehow had the residual effect of causing tiny squid to fall from the sky. A poster with the anatomy of a squid also appears in Topher's classroom, and a street cleaner comes by with the image of a squid on the back. Angela is making mooncakes for a presentation to the class, and the egg yolks splatter in the shape of a smiley face. Again, similar to the famous image from the graphic novel. Also in the classroom is a poster of the US presidents. It shows that Robert Redford is the current president of the United States. In the graphic novel, after the disaster, a news report mentions that Robert Redford is a potential serious candidate for president, as an alternative to Nixon. We also get a look at some airships in this episode. In the graphic novel, Dr. Manhattan's work helped create airships that are economical. A newspaper headline shows that Adrian Vate has been officially declared dead. Vate is the real name of Ozymandias in the graphic novel. However, Vate, as portrayed by Jeremy Irons, is later shown in the episode and is clearly not dead. In the background of Vate's dining room, a Roman helmet is on a table. A very similar helmet appears in the graphic novel on one of Vate's shelves. The sheriff also ends the police meeting with the quote,
"Quis custodiat ipsos custodes?"
This is Latin for, "Who will watch the watchman?" The titular line from the graphic novel, which can be seen scrawled in graffiti. Angela's passcode for her secret room is 1985, the year in which the events of the original graphic novel take place. On the sheriff's desk is a book titled Under the Hood. This is the autobiography of Hollis T. Mason, the first night owl from the graphic novel. Excerpts from Under the Hood appear at the end of the first five chapters. During the interrogation, Looking Glass asks the suspect, "Do you believe that transdimensional attacks are hoaxes staged by the United States government?" This is again a reference to the monster attack from the graphic novel. Nixon is depicted on Mount Rushmore during the interrogation scene. In this alternate history, he was never impeached, and was likely considered a hero for destroying the monster and avoiding nuclear war. During the interrogation, they also show several Rorschach blots on the screen, and another squid. The owl ship the sheriff rides in is similar to the one Night Owl had from the graphic novel. Owl imagery also appears a few times in the episode. Angela is sipping out of an owl mug, and an owl flies across the screen in a promo for American Hero Story. In the preview for the program, they show all of the original Minutemen, which were a group of superheroes from 1939. This poster in the 7th Cavalry's ranch house shows Dollar Bill, aka William Brady, who was a bank-sponsored superhero and one of the Minutemen. He died in 1947. We see a character with a rope around his neck several times in the episode. This is the vigilante Hooded Justice, who was allegedly the first superhero, according to the first Night Owl. Senator Joe Keane is mentioned on the radio. This might be a relative of the US Senator John Keane, who passed the eponymous Keane Act, which outlawed costumed adventuring in 1977 in the graphic novel. The very end of the episode shows an old man sitting next to the sheriff, who has been hanged. This old man is the same person as the little boy we saw in the beginning of the episode in 1921. He has the same mole on his cheek and holds the note his father placed in his pocket. Earlier in the episode, he asks Angela if she thinks he can lift 200 pounds, foreshadowing the murder. The song Poor Judd is Dead from the musical Oklahoma plays during the final scene and includes the lyric It's Summer and We're Running Out of Ice, which is the title of this episode. Fittingly, the now-dead sheriff's name is also Judd. The ending of the episode comes full circle and is evocative of the first scene, the black-and-white movie in which a corrupt sheriff was caught around the neck with a rope. And lastly, the very final shot of the episode is yet another reference to the blood-spattered smiley face, this time on the sheriff's badge. Did we miss anything? Let us know in the comments.